Hello.
Hi.
Hi, how you pronounce your name?
Hi. Oh, I'm so happy to see you.
How you pronounce your name?
Caron.
Caron. Okay. Yeah. Forgive my voice, I still don't completely have my voice back yet.
Okay.
So again, now, are you in the UK?
Yes.
Okay. Now, Caron, how have you found out about me?
Well, on YouTube, as it goes, I went onto YouTube and I was doing a lot of research on different things. And I looked at Krista Sala and looked at various ones. And then I came across you. And you look a bit like my mum, to be honest. You look a bit like my mum. So that drew me to you. And then I listened to a lot of your deliverances and everything. And I thought, yeah, I'm going to go with you.
Okay. Praise God. All right, so what is it that you expect God to do for you, Lady Caron? Because he only fulfilled our expectations.
Well, I want to be delivered from, I can feel like a presence around me. And I feel actively. Down below as well.
Okay, now could you repeat that? Because you were breaking up as you was talking.
And I just feel like, oh, breaking up, sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, this has been going for about 16 months now.
No, 16 months? Could you repeat it? Because the internet interfered as you was talking and I couldn't understand you. But could you repeat what you were saying?
Heard from the presence that I can feel around me, and the fact that I'm getting so, like, I can feel activity in my private area.
Okay.
So I know it's not natural.
No. That is spirit. Spirit husband, spirit spouse, spirit of love, snakes. Now, do you feel any movement in your belly area? Is there any type of movement you be feeling in your body?
Yes.
Snake, okay.
Yes.
Okay, so Caron, that tells me that those spirits enter you when you were a child. You were molested through a molestation.
Yes.
Molestation is simple. Not just a penetration, but a child coming to the knowledge of sex. Mm-hmm. Not about sex, and it's not really their time. The devil prematurely brings them into that knowledge. That child is being molested.
Yes.
And demons, as spouses, connect and join themselves to that child. As a matter of fact, the Lord told me that they go to Satan, since Satan is their master, asking him for certain little children. I like him, I like her,
yes.
I want them. And so that's the way that they enter that child, because of the parent. The parent rejecting God as their covering, so therefore the child don't have a spiritual covering, because their covering, the parent, don't have a spiritual covering. So that's what happened, that childhood molestation. For these spirits, they enter you and they call you to do ungodly things as you continue to grow up as a young girl. Yeah, that's good love. Now, when you became born again, Caron,
yes,
it was just your spirit that was birthed into the house of God, the family of God. You had the same soul, which is mind, will, emotion, and the same body. And the devils that take up residence in those areas were still in there. That's why Jesus delegated authority to his body on earth. Those who have his spirit living in them and been led and guided by his Holy Spirit, and they believe in Jesus, everything that Jesus does and stands for, they believe in Jesus. And there's power in him because of power in his name. They consist of the church, his body on earth. He delegated authority to them to confront those demons in the soul realm and the body, and commanded them to come out. Now, Ari, child of God can do it, because they don't have the knowledge of who the demon is, and they don't have faith in God.
Yes.
No, even though they claim they do, but they really want. It's like they limit the Holy Spirit. They limit the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit cannot use them. So that's what happened when you came to the Lord. So how long have you been serving the Lord?
Well, I was baptized when I was 14 years old. I grew up in the church from a baby, the Pentecostal religion, and I was baptized at 14. And I was kind of filled as well with the Holy Spirit. I was really into the church and into young people's choir and everything. And then I rebelled at school. You know, as you get to 15 and 16, I started to rebel and against all the strict rules and everything. And then I got pregnant at 17.
So how old were you when you became serious about God? Because we all can count back when we gave our heart to the Lord, but we really wasn't serious. When was it when you really became serious, Caron, about serving the Lord with all your heart? Mm-hmm.
Serious, I would say 2 years now. 2 years I've been on, I've just been one tracked on God for 2 years. I don't smoke, I don't drink, I dress moderately now. I don't have boyfriends. I'm celibate. I don't have sexual issues with anyone. You know, so I've cleaned up my act. I really have.
You clean it up, and you're not intentional with sin. Because our God children would come to him for deliverance, and they are still living in sin. They're still sinning. And demons not going to leave because you give them legal right to stay. You have their goods. You love what they do for you. So they're not going to leave. And they, you know, because the person has not cleaned up their act. We got a part to play. You know, we have to stop sinning. And then God will do what we can't do, which is get those demons out of us, because they shouldn't be living in the child of God. Now they're outside, and they're going to be there until their appointed time, but they don't have no business in our mind with emotional body controlling us and telling us to contrary things to the law and the word of God. Unless they cast out, you know, we won't have that control. We won't have full control of our soul and full control of our body, because those spirits will dictate to us what we should and shouldn't do. And they love coming against God. Okay? So let me ask you, now that child of molestation, you don't have to call out no name. And I know the Holy Spirit brought it back to your memory, because that's something he told me he would do. Once I mentioned it to a person, he would bring a particular image and thought back to their mind. So what has the Holy Spirit revealed to you about their childhood molestation?
Well,
you don't have to call no names.
No, I won't call any names, but I'll just say that in the household that I grew up in, I saw a lot of things.
That's mainly how it occurs in the household, because I was molested. My mother's oldest brother molested me, and more of his sisters.
Mm-hmm. My eldest sister, when she came over from Jamaica, she did some sexual things with us.
Mm-hmm. That's because those things were done to her. Mm-hmm. That's molested. Because the molested always becomes a molestor because of what a person may say, because those spirits are in the person. That's why you really can't blame the individual, because they are a victim too. She was molested. Devil tricked her just like he tricked you. And that's why it's important that we forgive the human being, because if we don't forgive the human being, our Father in heaven is not going to forgive us. You see? Because when you really get close to Jesus, you will actually see your problem do not come from people. It comes through people, but not from people. Your problem will come from the demonic spirits that we cannot see with our natural eye. Okay? And see, they are in you. It's amazing, Caron. I'm talking to you, and they are in you, looking at me right through your eyes.
Really?
Right through your eyes, and they really do not like what I just said. I saw it in your eyes. But they're coming out. Jesus is going to set you free. Now, Caron, he's going to set you free. And I'm going to share some things after your deliverance that you're going to have to do to maintain your freedom. Because it's an easy thing for Jesus to set us free. But it's up to us to stay free. Now, when we set us free, we are free indeed. Because I have faith in his word.
Yeah.
I say he's waiting right now for me to decree his will to be done on earth, which is your freedom. And he's going to do it in heaven. He's the one who's going to snatch those spirits out of you as I decree it. But I must decree it on this earth. You know, just like in the court system, the lawyer must decree something before the judge, you know, allow it to come to pass. But Jesus is the judge, you see. So it's easy for Jesus to set us free, but the individual, I don't know why they find it so hard and difficult. It's not. All you just need to do is keep submitting to God in everything that you do. Demons would flee from you, and they would run from you. Not just run, but they would run in terror. They would just live the scream, running away from you. So we are God's children. Don't have no business running from the devil, crying out every day, every second, what the devil is doing to us. He gets joy when we do that. Matter of fact, it strengthens him when we do that because it absolves him. We're not supposed to do that. We're supposed to rebuke him in Jesus' name and then exalt and give praise to our Heavenly Father with his Son, Jesus. Okay? That's all you have to do. And I'm going to share some things with you that you need to do so that you can give back the devil his goods. You're holding the devil goods. You're holding the devil goods on your persons in your house. And you're going to have to give it back to him in order for him to stay away, okay?
Say that again.
I say you are holding the devil's goods. His goods. Okay, I'm going to let you know what it is after your deliverance.
Okay.
And when I do, you obey the Holy Spirit's instructions in getting rid of it.
Of course.
Because we cannot stay free and we still got the devil's goods on our persons or in our house.
Okay.
We have to get rid of it. Okay?
Yes.
Remember now, the world is not our example of how we should dress or how we should look. The world is not our example. Okay. God's word told us women to dress modestly.
Yes.
Okay. Adornment and thoughts in the heart. It radiates on the outside. Okay. The world adorns the outside. Yes. Beautifies the outside while the inside is like dead men, dead people, graves, filthy. So what I'm going to do, Cameron, I'm going to pray for you first, and then I'm going to confront Spirit Husband. Now, Spirit Husband is the strong man, the leader. Yes. That's the leader. Okay?
Yeah.
When you bind the leader or the strong man.
Hold on. You've gone.
I'm gone?
Yes. Hang on. Let me just.
Okay. Yeah, because you froze.
What button do I press?
Yeah, you.
Yeah, okay. You're back.
Okay. Yeah, because you have froze too. But anyway, don't let devils deceive you and say, well, did you hear I called my name out so I didn't leave? I don't have to call all of the names. Only name the Holy Spirit gives me who is a strong man, the leader. When you bind a strong man, your sport is good. When you bind a strong man, those who under the strong man leadership scatters. They leave.
Yes.
Because their support, their strength is gone. So when I say Spirit Husband, you know, pack your things and everything that belongs to you and get out, it knows what I'm talking about. But don't let that spirit confuse your mind in trying to figure out what I'm talking about. Because by you doing that, you won't understand. And you end up opening the door for those spirits to come back because unbelief and doubt would open the door for them to come back. Okay? So that's why I said I'm going to pray for you first. And as I pray for you, then I'm going to front the spirit husband, the strong man. Remember, that conversation would be at him. What you do You just, within yourself, just be crazy and thanking God for setting you totally free. Don't let spirit of confusion, because that spirit tormented you for a long time. Confusion.
Yes.
Confusion is a spirit that serves the strong man. It serves your husband so that it can strengthen.
You're spot on. How do you know these things?
Huh?
How do you know this?
No, it's the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit tells us. Before we lean depend on the Holy Spirit, He tells us. I don't know nothing.
God, pray to God, you know, and I ask Him to send me to the right person. I prayed and
Yeah, the Holy Spirit. He loves us so. He wants us to have a relationship with Jesus. He wants to serve the Lord. But He knows that Jesus don't want just some of us, but He wants all of us. You know, some Christians satisfied with Jesus having their spirit, but Jesus don't have their soul, which is mind, will, emotion, and body. No, Jesus wants all of us. All of us. When we go to heaven, all of us go to heaven. Our spirit and our soul, and then our body is going to be resurrected to look like Jesus, where it won't be mortal anymore, it'll be immortal. Well, I look like my spirit in hell, but my soul's in hell, and I'm being tormented. So my mind, my will, emotion, I'm feeling everything in hell. No, we want our total being in heaven with the Lord. Don't say, well, don't let my spirit there. Mm-mm. No, your soul, you're going to feel that thing. If your soul go to hell, you're going to feel that torment. Because I'm like, so Jesus, through His Spirit, because the Spirit of God is Jesus, His Spirit. You know, when He walked on earth, He just had an earthly body. He couldn't be in us. He could be with the disciple, but He couldn't be in the disciple. But when He fulfilled His mission on earth and went back to the Father sent the promise, which was His Spirit. Now He can be with us and in us. And He talks to us, and He will reveal to us things, but we must lean the pen on Him. So no, I don't know anything. It's the Holy Spirit through me that knows you and knows those things. And He wants you to be totally free. Now, all you need to do, Caron, is receive by faith. Now, it's very important that you keep receiving by faith. Your evidence that Jesus set you free, Caron, is your faith in God's word. It's not in no manifestation, and rather you dreams have sex dreams, or demons showing your dreams, or you hear them knocking on the door, or whatever. You know, that is not your evidence that you've been set free. Or if you don't hear those things, that's still not your evidence that Jesus set you free. Mm-hmm. Your evidence, your faith in His word that He set you free. And when you believe His word and by faith, Satan cannot take that away from you. But if you go by your sight, or you go by your ears, or what you think as your evidence that He set you free, Satan can take that away from you. And you're still a confused young lady. See, me mess all the time. Terry, Avengers King, they're bad. They torment me. No. That's because you're looking at those things as your evidence that He set you free. You rebuke those things, and you praise and thank God that by faith you believe His word. You know, you're His child. And you ask Him to set you totally free so you can serve Him, and He done that. And you keep believing, and you keep praising Him and thanking Him for it. Okay? So I'm going to go ahead and pray now in Jesus' name. So, Father, in Jesus' name again, I thank You for this opportunity You have given me to minister Your love and grace and mercy to Your children, Your dear daughter, Caron. And I thank You for strengthening each and every day my voice, giving me my voice back, so that I can proclaim Your word, Your truth, Your Son, Jesus Christ, to Your dear children. Father, hear Caron. Oh, it truly is her desire. For You look deep down in her heart and You see, finally, Lord, You said finally she desires and wants to serve You with all her being, not just her spirit, but a soul, a mind, a will, emotion, and a body. Her desire is only to please You, Father. She is willing to take up her cross and go for it, Lord. And Father, as always, you're willing to help her carry her cross. And I thank you, Father, for giving her the inward strength that she needs day by day to make it on this earth and fulfilling your plan and accomplishing your purpose for her life. For they truly shall come to pass. And it all's going to boil down to her giving only glory to your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for the ministering spirits who is always with her, always encourage her when she don't even know that they are encouraging her. She don't even know when they take their right hand and place on her head and gave her strength. She wondered many times where that little strength came from. And it came from you as you sent the angels to anoint her head with oil. And I thank you, Father, for setting her apart and using her, Father, and bringing glory to your Son, Jesus. And the doors that the enemy has sealed off to her, and it was your will for those doors to be opened. I decree in the atmosphere right now, angels, go forth and open every door that the enemy had closed off the camera, that it was the Father's will to be open. And those doors that the enemy opened that was not the Father's will, I decree right now, angels, go forth and close those doors. Relationships that was not of the Father, angels, go forth in Jesus' name and disconnect those relationships in Jesus' mighty name. And I thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, that again, your plan and purpose for her life, it shall be fulfilled. I thank you for cleaning your vessel, your house, for her body is the temple only for the Holy Ghost. And I thank you for cleaning her this day, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. So right now, in Jesus' name, I take authority and I speak and I command you, dear husband, you come to attention. Come to attention. I want you to gather all your loads. Everything that belongs to you. Grab it, bind it around your waist, and get out of God's house. You are trespassing. You are trespassing, and you have no legal right there. In Jesus' name, I command you to loose her mind. Get your things and get out of her mind. Out. Everything that is not of the house of a God, get out. Turn loose her will. Turn it loose. You have no legal right. Loose her will. Come out of her emotions. Take everything that belongs to you and get out. Get out of her emotions. For the blood of Jesus commands you. And gather all that belongs to you that you planted in her body. And get out. Every spirit on the sound of my voice, you are not of the household of God. You are hiding in her body. I command you in Jesus' name to get her body out. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you to get out of her body. Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name, search and destroy all manner of spirits that is lurking and hiding in her mind. Go deep, deep down in the conscious, the subconscious memory of her mind. Set ablaze every unclean spirit. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn every negative image, picture that's been embedded in her mind. Burn, Holy Ghost, just ransacke her mind by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire, wash your mind rinse clean, redeem, purify her mind, in and with, and baptize her mind, in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn every spirit that is still trying to hold onto her will. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost. Everything that's holding onto her will that is not of you, burn, Holy Spirit. Burn by your consuming fire in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, purify, and baptize, oh will, in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, go deep, deep down in her emotion. Set ablaze every spirit that's still trying to hold on to her emotion. Burn everything in her emotion that don't act or react like you. They don't act nor react like you. They don't move like you. Set them ablaze. Burn them all. Burn Holy Ghost. All manner of darkness in her emotions. Burn. Burn Holy Spirit. Ransack her emotion by your consuming fire. In Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse. Clean, redeem, purify. Ransom and baptize her emotions in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn all manner of spirits that comes up, looks out through the window of her eye. Burn snakes in her eye. Burn lust. Burn around her eyes, the front, the back, and the sides of her eyes. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack her eyes by your consuming fire. Burn all that is not of you in her eyes. Burn, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, wash her eyes. Clean, redeem, ransom, and baptize her eyes in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, even burning her nose, burning her mouth, burning her ears. Burn all manner of spirits, her eyes and her nose, ears and mouth. Set them all ablaze. Just ransack her nose, her mouth and her ear. Ransack it, Holy Ghost. Don't leave nothing in untouched in her nose, mouth, and ear by your consuming fire. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem, purify, baptize her nose, mouth, and ear in and with the blood of Jesus. Even her throat, Holy Ghost. Burn darkness that even high up and down her throat. Set her throat ablaze, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit, everything that's not of you in her throat. Set ablaze. Burn, Holy Spirit. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem, purify. Ransom and baptize her throat in and with the blood of Jesus. Holy Ghost Spirit, fire. Go deep, deep down in her belly. Burn all manner of spirits that is hiding deep, deep down in her belly. Burn those spirits, Holy Spirit. Burn those evil spirits. Look like animal, insect, sea creature. Even take on human appearances, shapes, and forms. Set them all ablaze. All that's not of you in her belly. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn those snakes and their eggs in her belly. Burn, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Burn in her fallopian tube, in her womb, in her uterus. Holy Ghost fire, burn every plant. My heavenly Father had not planned. Uprooted and burned. And consume it by your fire in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, purify, ransom and baptize her belly, her womb, her uterus, and her fallopian tube, in and with the blood of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, burn even in her vagina. Go deep, 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 up and down and around in her vagina. Burn everything that's not of you. Burn, Holy Ghost, just ransack her vagina. In the mighty name of Jesus. Burn everything in her vagina that moves. Burn, Holy Ghost. Set ablaze. Set ablaze. Burn, 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 burn all spiritual parts. Burn those spiritual tools inserted in her vagina. Burn, Holy Spirit. Everything that's in there that's not of you. Set ablaze. set her ablaze in Jesus' name, even in her rectum. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn all manner of spirit that's hiding in her rectum. The inserted tools and objects in her rectum. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn everything that's not of you. Ransack her rectum by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, purify, ransom, and baptize vagina and rectum in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn on her breath. Burn on her breath. Burn everything that's been planted in her breath. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn up and down her arm, up and down her leg. Burn all the rings on her finger. Burn them off. Rings on her toes. Burn them off. Burn chains wrapped around her body. Burn it off. Burn that evil crown. Burn that evil crown. Burn on top of her head, on her forehead. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn every mark that was made, known or unknown to her. Burn those evil marks, evil carving, evil piercing. Burn every hole that's been made in and on her body. Set it all ablaze. Burn every image that was made in and on her body, known or unknown to her. Set it all ablaze. Burn up and down her back, up and down her lid. Don't leave no area untouched, from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Everything that's not of you, burn it all. Burn it all, Holy Ghost. Set it ablaze. Burn all falseness on her head. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn all manner of spirits in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, wash your body, clean her body, redeem her body, purify her body, ransom and baptize her body, in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, in the spirit realm, I take the sins of God, I cut and detach Cameron from that evil spirit marriage. I just disconnect her from that evil spirit marriage, the evil spirit husband, evil spirit wife, the evil spirit children, the entire evil spirit family. Every relationship in the spirit realm that Heavenly the Father did not connect her to. I disconnect her because the blood of Jesus disconnects her and sets her totally free by his shed blood. Even in the natural realm, every relationship my Heavenly the Father did not connect Cameron to. I disconnect her because the blood of Jesus disconnected her and sets her free in Jesus' mighty name. Cameron, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you be totally free to serve the Lord in your mind. Be totally free in your will. Be totally free in your emotion. Be totally free in your dreams, in your vision, in your business, in your affairs. And you be totally free in your body to serve the Lord in spirit and truth. Him only shall you serve this day forward until the forever. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. Father, fill your daughter to overflow with your spirit. Fill her mind, her will, her emotions, her body, her dreams, her visions, her affairs, and her business to overflow with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. And Father, I also pray for Cameron Lee. Holy Ghost, sick of you know exactly where to move. Seek and destroy all darkness hiding place. Go in every corner, crack, and crevice of the house of the rose and destroy darkness. Go in every bedroom and destroy darkness that's hiding under the bed, over the bed, around the bed, on top of the bed, in between the sheets and the mattress, and destroy darkness. Destroy darkness attached to objects that's even unknown to Cameron. Destroy those evil objects. Destroy all the hiding places. Even go on the outside. Go around the house, over the house, under the house, even the underground, and destroy darkness. Holy Ghost fire, destroy evil objects that have been planted in her name, in her family name, that have been scattered on top of the earth, thrown in the waters, buried under the earth. Destroy those evil objects. And you know exactly where to find. Destroy them all. Cameron knows nothing about how people have stole objects from her to put curses on her. And I thank you for destroying those objects. Also, Holy Ghost, destroy every covenant, contract, and agreement written in her name, in her family name, that was written on top of the earth, written underwater, even underground, even in the heaven. Destroy the covenant, contracts, and agreements in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you for placing angels around her, protecting her wherever she may go, placing her in a fiery bubble of the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father, for making her off limits and giving her peace, peace in her heart, peace in her mind, peace wherever she may go. Thank you, Father, for this day setting this captive totally free. And Father, we thank you because we know you are present, because you stated that you were. If we even two or more of us gather together in your son's name, you are truly in the midst. We might not can see you with our physical eyes, but our spiritual eyes and our spiritual knowing know that you are here because you are faithful to your word. And I thank you, Jesus, for setting your daughter free. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Sister Cameron, it's done in Jesus' name. It's done. You are free. That means, again, demons are not in you no more. They're not in you. You hear me, Cameron? I don't know if you froze the internet, froze or not. I think it is. But you probably can hear me. But they are not in you. And Jesus cast them out of you. So you are free. Free to serve him in your mind, your will, your emotion, and in your body. So if you, okay, you know what, we got disconnected, her internet probably kicked off. So wait till she signed that coin. But Cameron is free. You know what, we got to learn to receive things by faith. Praise God for ministries that is on internet TV, regular TV, that shows us how God is setting captives free, and we see manifestations of demons. And praise God for that. And God does that for the unbeliever. But we are believers. It don't take all that for us to believe God, because we believe his word. It's a wicked, perverse generation that seeks after a sign. I always want to see something. We receive by faith. So praise God for those ministries. But I'm saying the devil is using those ministries to get you not to believe that God set you free just through a simple word. We have to receive by faith. Not all the time will the Lord allow demons to manifest. He does that to perfect our faith in him. Now remember, Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith. So some of us, he's not going to allow us to see and feel demons leave. We have to trust him, believe him, believe his word that he did it. And he did. And it is a case if he allow us to see or not. We receive by faith that he set us free. You know, there are a lot of things I wanted to see in the spirit realm, especially the angels of God. Lord said, Terry, when you believe without seeing first, then I'll let you see. I said, yes, Lord. So that's what pleased God. It's when we have faith in his word. Don't it please you when you tell someone you're going to do something and you have every intent to do it? And they say, oh, thank you, I believe you. That pleases you. But they say, I don't believe you. That don't please you, and that don't make you do anything either. No. Well, how much more is our Heavenly Father? So we got to learn how to receive by faith. Whatever we receive from God, it's by faith. That's our life. That's how we live. Remember the word said to just live by faith. We live by faith, y'all. Faith in the similar. See, the demons know that we don't see a thing. They done seen. They done seen God. They know God is real. They know how powerful God is. They know God is faithful to his word. They know. Why? Because they done seen. They was in heaven. They was in heaven. But see, they know we ain't seen a thing. And they say, oh, man, it's a good opportunity for us to keep them in deception because they can't see. They got to believe without seeing. So we're just going to. We liars anyway because our father is a liar. But we're going to keep lying to them. It ain't no God. God ain't going to do this. God ain't going to do that. He don't love you. He's not going to fulfill his word in you. But we're just going to tell them the opposite. Since they can't see anything, they can't see him, they're going to believe him. Behold, some of God's children believe him. That's why it's important that we believe God. We believe God. Keep believing him until the end. Because he or she will endure to the end, shall be saved. You're going to be happy. Oh, Jesus, you'll follow his feet. Oh, Jesus, thank you. Thank you for not letting me give up. Give me. Come close many times and not believe him, but I refuse. Oh, look what I would have missed if I didn't just believe your word. You know, Jesus said when he returned, will he find him? But this is what Jesus is going to look for. He's going to look for faith. Faith on earth. As time grows closer and closer to the end, mankind's faith weakens. The devil's working just that much over time to store people's faith in God. And that's why you see people, so many people with such a cold heart. The heart has grown cold to God because they don't believe. Don't believe. So believe. Again, we receive whatever we receive from God, believe. God sent his anointed and appointed servant to set us free, to decree on this earth his will to be done as it is in heaven. You must believe that he did it in heaven, because he did. I'm telling you. I'm trying to lengthen this out because Cameron has not returned. I'm on her internet. But I will share this with you. The very first time when Lord called me, he found me. Thank you, Lord. Found me. But I must say, I wasn't looking for him. But I didn't. How can you live with someone when you don't know them? So don't say you found the Lord. No, he found you. His grace and mercy found us. So he found me and he made himself known to me. Wow. I believe by faith. And I put one and one together, things that happened to me as a little girl. And that was God, a rejected little child, even to this day. But Jesus never rejected me. He made himself known to me as my loving big brother. He introduced me to my heavenly father. But my earthly father rejected me. I was a little girl. Jesus did that to him. Right around 5. And he sent angels. I talked to one of them when I was a little girl to protect me from things. I thought no demons were things. There were number of demons then. But Lord opened my spiritual ears and I heard them. Oh, hideous sound. And I was so scared. The Lord, through my angel, assured me they couldn't touch me. God is good, ain't he, Lord? Nobody was serving the Lord. Everybody. Grown ups was in the witchcraft. Oh, everybody. All of them was in the witchcraft. Then, sinners practicing sin. But the Lord saw that little rejected girl. And he knew that I was chosen to be in his kingdom and protect me. But when I became around my early 30s, that's when I really became serious about the Lord. And I found him. He found me even more. If he found me, then that's when I found him. I began to learn a lot about him, a whole lot. And I learned he was real. Hear me, Joy, he was real. I couldn't see him, but I knew he was real. Holy Spirit. And I remember the very first time, ain't another about these spiritual things. He wanted me and my husband to go pray for this woman who was dying of cancer. And this cousin of mine who rarely speaks to us called us and told us to go see her. And I knew that was Jesus Christ because she wouldn't have done that. So here I was eager to do the things of the Lord. I said, sure. And I told my husband, he went too. Praise God. being listened to a godly wife. Praise his holy name, the Lord now. Thank God for my husband. I'm talking about praise his holy name, the Lord. But in the way we went. But when I was standing there looking at her, I heard the Spirit of the Lord say, take the anointed oil and anoint her leg. So I said, sister, because she was laying on the couch. I said, let me anoint your legs. She's okay. And I had no idea if she was in pain or not. I just heard the Lord say, anoint her legs with oil. So I put the oil on my hand and I started at her toes. And slowly went up her leg. As I slowly was going up her leg, she said, ah, that feels so much better. Ah, that feels good. So apparently she had pain in her legs. But as I was doing it, my right foot hit or tapped someone's left foot. So I said to myself, Why is Roger standing so close to me? And I could tap his leg, but I was still rubbing her leg. Then a voice said, look down at your feet. Well, I looked down at my feet. Roger's leg wasn't there. He was way on the other side of the room. I said, my foot tapped somebody's foot. And that's when Jesus said, That was my foot. Right there, dear heart, I realized that Jesus was with me. When I reached out my hand and laid it on her, Jesus told me he placed his hand under my hand, and it was his hand that was healing and soothing her leg. And as I stepped out in faith and done his work, he stepped into me and was doing his work through me. And I realized then that Jesus is real and that he is with us, not just in us, because of his spirit of God in Jesus Christ, and spirit, which enabled him not to just be with us, but in us. And he was doing those things. And I had another experience the same thing when I ministered his word on a local television station. The same thing. Jesus stepped into me and started speaking. And there I was, like I had sat in front of Jesus in a chair, listened to him, using my body, using my mouth, my faculties, and teaching the people. And I'm sitting there listening to him and learning too. And I'm saying to myself, Lord, do people think this is me teaching them? And it's really you, because I don't know these things. I'm learning them too. You know what? That is when I learned Jesus is real. He's with us and he's in us. Whenever he gives us work to do, we step out in faith to do it. He's right there. He steps into us. He's the one who's doing it. So when devils look at us, they're looking at Jesus. And that's why they back away. They're not backing away from us. They're backing away from Jesus, because they're seeing Jesus in us, Christ in us, the hope of glory. He's in us. When they look in my eye, they don't see my eyes, they see Jesus. Some of you right now, you can't even bear to look in my eye. Even though I'm hoarse, you can't even stand and listen to my voice. And my voice is hoarse. But it's not me, it's Jesus Christ. The continence on my faith, you can't even stand. I'm recuperating from a sickness. And the continence on my faith, you can't even bear to stand and look at it. That's Jesus. Them demons in you can't stand seeing the Christ in me. And you need to live. Praise the living God. So I want to share that with you, to have faith. Cameron's not back yet on her internet. So if she's not bad, hopefully she'll go on YouTube and listen to that session. And you hear all of this, what I'm telling her. And I'm going to go ahead and tell you, Cameron, what I wanted to tell you and maintain your deliverance. Now, your hair. Now, if that hair is not your hair, if it's not the real deal, the real thing, if it's not the glory that God has given you, that means that is the devil's good. You are wearing his good, and you need to get it off your head and give it back to him, okay? Also, you need to go to your wardrobe, ask the Holy Spirit to show you every item that you purchased, and the spirit python snakes in you was the one who enticed you to purchase that wardrobe to get rid of. You may ask, well, how would I know? Well, if you put it on and it makes you feel sexy, that was not the Holy Spirit. That was python snakes. Because sexiness had nothing to do with a woman of God. We dress modest. It's okay to look nice in your color, but not sexy. Sexiness is meant to allure, attract, not just men, but women into lust, to promote lust, to keep the spread of lust, or maintain lust in a person. That's the reason why python snake have women and men to dress sexy. And that's the reason why they have you to buy those clothes, so you get rid of it. Objects in your home, your jewelry, ask the Holy Spirit about your jewelry. Your rings, ask the Holy Spirit about your rings. Just ask the Holy Spirit about is there, show you, because we don't know all. Show you if there is anything in your house that is displeasing your Father's sight, that was hindering his presence. Show you, and if you get rid of it, don't give it away, you destroy it. Watch your friends. If you have friends, their conversation is always perverse. It don't lead you to Christ Jesus. You know it don't. Those are friends you love from a distance. You can't fellowship with them. I have no fellowship with darkness. If you did before, that was because darkness was in you. The darkness in you fellowship with the darkness in them. The darkness is no longer in you, Caron. So you don't fellowship with them. You love them from a distance. Contacts on your phone, on your email. Do you know they're not people again that build your relationship with the Lord? You get rid of those contacts, okay? Is there anyone the Holy Spirit is telling you to go ask for forgiveness because of some wrong you may have done to them? You do it. It don't matter how big or small the outward, you ask them to forgive. If they choose not to forgive you, that is on them. It's not on you. But you do your part, Caron. So I know the Holy Spirit is going to tune you in to listen and watch your session. I'm trying to wait a while, see if you call back in. Okay? But praise the living God. You are set free. If the devil tried to come to you in a dream in any way to discourage you and that you're not set free, after you wake up, you rebuke that dream because that dream was not of the Father. Any dream that you have that would cause you to be confused, Caron, known as Caron, but all of you all who listen, that called confusion, that dream was not from God. The dream was from the devil to keep you confused, to keep your mind away from the Lord. Such dreams you rebuke in Jesus' name, that I don't receive that dream. No, I don't receive that dream. It doesn't build me up in Christ Jesus. I don't receive that dream. I bind that dream and cast it back to the sender in Jesus' name. Then you no longer think or meditate over that dream or don't even speak of the dream, but you praise and thank God for setting you totally free. And all day, every day, give thanks in everything. It don't matter how long it takes, you continue to do that. As you continue to do that, Satan will get tired of you and say, let me leave. I'll come back later on. But when he come back later on, let him find you still submitting to God in praise and worship to him. Praise him and worship him. So I'm going to go ahead and end this session. Again, Caron, having a good chance. Now remember, I also remember the offer of those who tune in. You take this for yourself. What the things I will tell you, Caron, It's for us all. Okay, you take it personally. And if the Holy Spirit has convicted you that you need deliverance, you know devils are on the inside of you. You know you're doing things you got no business. That's the devil on the inside of you. So mind, will, emotion, body. And then they got to be cast out by an anointed, appointed servant of God. Okay, so go to the website, thechildrensmite.org/deliverance. Follow the instructions. Now, I'm not going to contact you unless you follow the instructions. And then after you follow the instructions to install Zoom Cloud Meetings, then I will contact you and give you the meeting ID and we can get together for your deliverance. Be willing to give up your reputation, because I'm definitely going to talk to you and not giving up your reputation. Before you got to give up your reputation. Jesus gave up his. We cannot hold on to our reputation. But the gift of God our honor. That includes our reputation. Who do we think we are anyway? I don't want nobody to see me. I'm a well-known person. I got a channel on YouTube. I'm well-known. I got a program on TV. I'm a well-known person. And I don't want people to know this. You making God's kingdom at Nicodemus, you rather give up your reputation. Why you like Nicodemus, you come by night. Bench King, but in this case, Bench King, can I have a private session? I don't want to be seen. Answer is no. You have to give up your reputation. And you know why? You hold on to your reputation, and them devils ain't going nowhere. They ain't going nowhere because you give them legal right to stay, because you hold on to your reputation. Again, who do we think we are? Hold on to our reputation. When our Father, Son, Jesus Christ, gave up his reputation for us, and we want to hold on to our puny reputation, we need to die to self in Jesus' name. So again, dear heart, Caron haven't returned. So stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Shalom.